This place will eat you alive if you let it. This place will tear your flesh from bone with its teeth, with its scalpels. This place will dissect you limb by limb, flame tender skin, naming every imperfection with a razor blade. This place is dissection, where two hemispheres of left brain and right brain no longer neatly bisect but slide together like a jumbled Venn diagram. This place is waiting rooms and waitlists. This place is waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. This place is the inner workings of my slowly decaying mind. As I try to find help in the labyrinth of the resigned, it's like a carnival ride has met a crime scene and I can't get out this time. Authorities have been alerted, but nobody seems inclined to offer any assistance. I feel like I'm walking around with a ticking time bomb in my brain as I try to survive what I am told is another impending psychotic break. I have known a lifetime of OCD, depression, and anxiety, and while experienced with dissociative drug-induced psychosis, I'm waiting on results from more extensive diagnosis. I've had 3 involuntary hospitalizations this year alone. I just want a place to go home to. Not a home with a roof over my head, a home inside my head. A place I can go where I'm not afraid to close my eyes, unsure of what I'll see behind them tonight. They're drawing new borders and lines through my disordered personality. Every corner of my cortex is becoming uncharted territory. I'm wary of every bump in the night. Was that real, or am I hearing things? I don't know which is worse, fear or paranoia. I just want it all to stop. And I want to stop writing about it. I'm sick of feeling like my trauma is what defines me. I spent way too much time in hospitals and institutions to let loss and delusion rule my art. I'm sick of feeling like sex cells have become pain cells and we're all just trading points on our emotional stock market. But I have nothing else to tell you. All I feel is pain. Addiction is a lifelong commitment, whether you're feeding it or fighting it. Mental illness is a lifelong experience, whether you're living, surviving, or recovering from it. I was waiting for the day I would feel better and write new poems. I realize now, this is who I am. Real growth often happens in the spaces we least expect. To what Dr. Seuss calls the waiting place. In the 17 months I was on a wait list for treatment, I grew more than the previous 17 years combined. I take that as a testament to the empowerment one can draw from a very, very sick mind. This place will eat you alive if you let it. But you have teeth and tongue and carry strength in your body.